Hey, unexpected events happening around here. What is that, like a bicycle race or something like that? I'll go capture some more later, I guess. It looked kind of interesting. Tons of people outside too. And I guess with that in mind, it was kind of interesting reading this story. I know a lot of people are paranoid, like for example, when there's a drone there, it's going to be spying on you and so forth. But in reality, for consumer drones, you can't really see anything because everyone's like a dot with wide angle lens. But how about this one here? This one says, a custom police drone to locate individuals in the crowd. And I guess here they would envision that kind of technology being used for emergency situations. It says here, the final whistle sounds. 50,000 people leave the stadium and one of them collapses due to a heart attack. A smart drone instantly locates the location of the victim so that the emergency services arrive at the moment. This fictitious example is a sample of how a new drone model developed by the Brno University of Technology in the Czech Republic and the police of this country can help in situations where there are large crowds of people such as football matches, demonstrations, rallies, or concerts. What makes it special is that its camera is capable of detecting atypical behaviors in crowds and pointing out where they occur on the screen so that they can be instantly evaluated by the operators who follow the images. So in some cases, I guess it's kind of like a thermal camera, or in this case, I guess an example would be if in the image, everyone looks like they're standing upright, and then all of a sudden it detects this one thing that looks like, I don't know, like a log in the ground, it'll determine, hey, something's wrong and get you to look at it. And they do say here, I guess this development was because law enforcement agencies specifically requested for it. It's kind of cool in one sense of saving lives, but I know the other end, people will be terrified of this because they will say this is basically monitoring people. I guess the biggest example is kind of like in China, all that social credit system and all that, cameras everywhere, it'll be kind of like that, I guess you could say. And I read this, I was wondering why is this popping up everywhere in the news all of a sudden? It dealt with a site called OnlyFans, where to my knowledge, it was supposed to be people where you could sign up and get exclusive things like videos and stuff from whoever it is you want to follow, like a celebrity. But the site is well known to have things like nudity and all that. That's what people do, I guess, to get the money in donations. But with that, apparently the site was going to ban things like adult content, which is a little weird for me to think about if that's what they're known for. As it says here, OnlyFans banned just the latest in campaign against adult content online, industry watchers say. Such platforms grow on the backs of sex workers, then force them out, says Advocate. That still doesn't really make sense where, again, that platform, to my knowledge, is known for things like adult content and they built their base that way. So then to get rid of it, I guess a lot of people are criticizing. They've basically grown so big that they don't care about, I guess you could say, the people that made them big and all that. Although they did say this, OnlyFans clarifies new policy. No sex, no extreme genitals, but sure, boobs are fine. And from my understanding, just reading some of the stuff, they're saying the reason that they had to do this is for their payment processor to actually allow them to use it, I guess, like things like Visa and MasterCard. I guess they won't allow explicit content, if that's what you want to say. To me, that's one of the most fascinating things about this story, because it's basically true in a lot of things where people would argue it's a company that has grown so big that they don't care about the people who helped them, I guess, on the way. And here it says, dear sex workers, the OnlyFans community would not be what it is today without you. The policy change was necessary to secure banking and payment services to support you. We are working around the clock to come up with solutions. But it seems like a lot of people, they're just not happy about it. For example, it looks like some people are saying they could have just used any other payment processor as opposed to just MasterCard and Visa. Some people just outright calling them liars, saying they're depriving millions of sex workers and so forth, where that's what they're relying on their sole income. Because even aside from what this site, I guess, is known for, again, you can actually transfer this to virtually any other site. Would you be on the side of the company here or with the people, I guess you could say, that created the content and helped make it big? All right. See you guys later.